Welcome to a gloriously sunny Silverstone. We're here for the second meeting of the BRSCC Toyo Tires Porsche Championship. And as you can see, the cars are lining up behind me, ready to go out for the first of three races this weekend.
Here's your first starting grid of the weekend then. Ed Hayes and Adam Southgate on the front row with Richard Avery and Nick Hull on the second. Gary Lawrence and Kevin Molyneux on the third row with Andrew Porter and Oleg Stocker. Then we have Andrew Baker, Pip Hammond and Gavin Johnson at the front row of the 924s for BBC Racing, with Ryan Lowry ahead of Philip Waters, Carl Rossin ahead of Stephen Potts, with Peter Smith, Jamie Callender and Darren House rounding out the grid. Should be an interesting one here this weekend. Great to see Kevin Molyneux and Alex Porter back in the championship again. No Rick Styron, of course, so the 924 should be an interesting one as well. Great start from Ed Hayes, but it looks as though Southgate's going to get a better one. Richard Avery's going to get past him as well, and even Gary Lawrence is trying to cut past Hayes. Hayes has got a terrible getaway, and through to the first corner. It's a magnificent start for Southgate. He leads. Stocker's going to get past Ed Hayes as well, and if he's not careful, Kevin Molyneux's going to get a run on as well. But it's Southgate who leads. Richard Avery is to his left, trying to go right round the outside as we go into farm for the first time, and Avery is not quite able to get the lead off Southgate, but what a battle we've got already. On board with our race leader. Look at the bumps that you bounce over to get himself back onto the hangar straight. He gets himself now onto that main straight. Power up through the gears. Game on for Adam Southgate, but he's got Richard Avery right on the tail. Gary Lawrence is there in third. It looks like Nick Hull has come up to fourth position, and Hayes has already made the move on Stocker. We're on board with Jamie Callender as he battles away in the 19-4s. Hopefully he's going to have a much better weekend than he had at Alton Park 2 weeks ago. Southgate in front of Avery as they come round Stowe Corner for the first time, back down to the Vale. And Southgate with a brilliant advantage to take his first win at the 2017 season in the Toyo Tires Porsche Championship. Gary Lawrence is closing up on the pair of them though for third position. This should be strong. Stocker's going to try and make a move back on the inside of Hayes, because Hayes has got past not only Stocker but also Nick Hull, and he's almost pushing them back into the pack of Kevin Molyneux with Porter in there as well. It's a shame we haven't got Coleman with us this weekend. He's not here, nor is Angus Archer, thanks to his engine going pop at Alton Park. But what a battle this is turning out to be. Southgate has got Richard Avery back to full speed and back on the pace. Here's Southgate, and Avery swarming all over the back of him. Look at Hayes dropping Stocker as Nick Hull runs in sixth position. Here comes Molyneux up the inside to try and move up into the top six. Not this time, Kevin. Try again, says Nick Hull. And Alex Stocker there in fifth position, running very well. There's Ed Hayes, having moved up now into fourth position, trying to give chase to the top three up front. Southgate leading, Avery second, and Lawrence third. We're back on board with Peter Smith, right in the mix of the 924s. He swerves right the way to the right to try and beat Gavin Johnson to the apex. He's got through. So Callender and Smith both get past Gavin Johnson on that occasion. Not sure what's happened to the BDC racing driver who started on the front row of the 924s, but he's now down in the pack. Back on board with Southgate. He's looking in his mirrors once, twice, three times. You don't want to look back, mate. You want to look forward. That's the only way you're going to win this race. Avery's swarming all over the back of him like a bad habit as they go through the chicane to club corner for the end of the lap. Looking back through the Porsche box of the field, there is Alex Stocker doing a cracking job in front of Nick Hull as they continue to try and get away from Kevin Molyneux. Avery is catching Southgate again, but look, Hayes is now right on the back of third position, Gary Lawrence. So Lawrence might not be able to get into third position. It's going very well for Alex Stocker as he runs in front of Hull. Here comes Avery, throws it to the left, trying to go right round the outside of Southgate as Hayes tries to do the same thing to Gary Lawrence behind them. We're on board with Southgate. He's frantically trying to figure out where Richard Avery is going. Is he coming to my left? Is he coming to my right? Well, Hayes is diving down the inside of Lawrence to take third position. So Hayes is back on the podium then. Down the hangar straight, under the bridge. This should be an interesting squabble. But which way is Avery going? He's in the draft at the moment. I can see in his left rearview mirror. Hayes has got Lawrence alongside him again down the hangar straight. He's going to have to shake him off as they go into Stowe Corner. Avery trying to go the long way round the outside of Southgate. And Avery leads. Avery leads. Brilliant overtaking move there from Richard Avery. That's the man who was runner-up in last year's championship. Back to his best. Great to see Richard in full fighting form once again. So Avery in the lead, second now Southgate, third is Hayes, fourth is Lawrence, and they're pulling away from the battle behind them. Still led by Stocker and Hull, with Molyneux and Porter in position behind them. But Southgate, now in second position, is having to try and get away from Hayes and get back on terms with Richard Avery. Through Abbey, good run this for Richard Avery. Great to see the blue, green and white machine back on full chat after his difficulties last time out. So maybe Richard Avery is going to take his first win of the 2017 season, although if he's not careful, Southgate is going to get in there. We ride back on board with the Avis consulting car. Number 45, big twitch of the steering as he comes off of Village. Dives down into the right-hander to get back onto the hanger straight. This is where all the speed comes in. Southgate trying to follow in Richard Avery's drop, but Avery darts across to the right-hand side. Now, where is Ed Hayes? There he is. He's right in behind Adam Southgate, so I don't think he'll get past him on this lap, but he's got a good chance on the next one if he keeps this kind of pace up. Ed Hayes is absolutely lightning at the moment in the 2017 season. Still going very well for Avery out front. Southgate in second. Third is Ed Hayes. We're back on board with Southgate as we go down towards the Vale chicane. Hayes is gaining a lot of time under traction. He really seems to be coping with the new aerodynamics of these cars, with the new front splitter, the new rear spoiler. It means you can be faster and more aggressive into the corners. You gain much more speed off the turn, and Hayes is gaining a lot of ground on Southgate. Look in the left rear mirror of Southgate's car. You can see how close Hayes is getting. Through the sweeping right-hander at Abbey Corner. Back up to the top. Hayes has got a good run on Southgate. If he can continue this, he might be able to get into second position into farm. Dives down for the inside. No, you don't. Southgate shuts the door firmly. That's great defensive driving from Southgate. He almost had one on Hayes at Alton Park 2 weeks ago. He really wants to beat him this time. But Richard Avery has the lead, but he's not getting away from these two, is he? This is an interesting battle, and it could go all the way to the death with these three. So Avery in front of Southgate and Hayes. And these three drivers battling away for the three steps of the podium at the moment. Here comes Hayes, up the inside. Southgate's not going to leave him enough room, so he's going to have to dart to the other side. Now, can he get him on the undercut? Southgate sweeps through Stone Corner, up on two curbs. Here we go. He got the outside line there. He's got another opportunity to go into the Vale. Hayes looks for the inside line, well held by Southgate, and that closes him up to Avery. Avery is really sweating buckets here. He's at the head of this trio, but he can't get away from Adam Southgate, who in turn can't get away from Hayes. Southgate has now got to attack Richard Avery. He's got to find a way to close up, and that is not going to be easy, given where we currently are. Into the first corner once again. Avery still hanging on in front of Adam Southgate, but Southgate is looking for that crucial manoeuvre. Up on the curbs, on the run to Village. Avery defends to the inside line. Looking back, we're just going to try and see where the 924s are at the moment. Pip Hammond still leading the way, I do believe, in the 924s, as he has been for pretty much the majority of. Avery still hanging on in front of Southgate. Then we've got Ed Hayes in third position. Plenty of curb on the exit as we come onto the hanger straight. Southgate's got a good run on Richard Avery. Under the hanger straight bridge, Avery makes Southgate go left. They're going to be door-to-door. Can he out-drag him to the braking zone? He squeezes Avery to the inside line. That's the shorter line. If he can go right round the outside, but he can't. Avery holds the inside line. And he needs to shut the door quickly because Hayes is going to be right there to capitalise. He's going to swarm around it. Here's the 924 battle. That is Gavin Johnson now in front of Phil Waters. Smith is in there, and so too, that looks to be Stephen Potts, the 25, in there as well. On board with Jamie Callender. He's trying to catch these four. Up on the curbs, out of Village, and down onto the hanger straight once again. Gavin Johnson having a great fight with Phil Waters at the moment. Is he going to be a PDC Racing 1-2? These guys are a long way behind Pip Hammond, who's having a great run now that he's got no Rick Styron to play with. Down the hanger straight for Jamie Callender. Looking good. Back to the leading battle, and still Avery holds the lead. Southgate in second. Hayes is swarming about, trying to get into P2, but he's really difficulty in trying to get through at the moment. Let's see if he can get back on terms. Southgate closes right up on Avery under braking. The car wobbles over the bumps. He manages to bring the car under control, though. There's a lot more stability in the car this year. Hayes is disappearing from the left-hand rearview mirror. He swarms back to the other side. Southgate holding the inside line, trying to catch the draft from Avery as Hayes goes to his left. They're going to be side by side, are they? No, Southgate shuts the door. Avery's braking very tentatively for Stoke Corner. Southgate's having to hesitate. Hayes can get a better run and get past him here. He goes right. Southgate cuts across. This is great battling between these three. Hayes is now alongside Southgate. Can he get right round the outside of him through Vale? He's gone the long way round, and Hayes is going to tuck back to the inside. Beautiful overtake from Ed Hayes. Back in a second position goes the 77. What an amazing run this is from Ed Hayes. He dropped back into what, sixth or seventh position at the start. Now he's fought his way to second. If he could deal with Richard Avery better than Southgate did, he could win this race. Absolutely amazing job from Ed Hayes in the 77. He's working so hard here on the back of Richard Avery. And now he's got a chance to win it. So they come back through the farm. Avery's overshot. Hayes is going to get right on the inside, and he shuts the door just in time, Richard Avery. That's held Hayes up. Now Southgate's got a chance. Hayes is going to squeeze into the outside line. If Southgate can get the switch back, he slides. That's cost him a chance to go for second position. So now Southgate has to pick up the pieces and give chase. But Hayes is now on the tail of Avery as we start to approach back markers in the 924s. Now, is Avery going to be able to hang on to this in front of Ed Hayes, or is the 77 going to dart through and get his third win of the season? Avery, the runner-up from last year, don't forget. Back on the main straight with the battlers in the 924s. That is Carl Rossin in front of Ryan Lowry. We're back on board with Jamie Callender as he continues to chase after the Johnson, Waters, Smith squabble. Looks as though Stephen Potts has gone from it. Not sure what happened to him, but it's going to be a really interesting battle. If these guys pick their way through the 924s at the wrong moment, it could change the face of the race. Southgate, look, is dropping off the back of Avery and Hayes. These two are disappearing. Avery cuts across to cover Ed Hayes, and there is the 25 of Stephen Potts in front of us, so he's lost ground. But is Ed Hayes going to be able to pick up the lead of this race through the traffic? He's having a squabble as they come round the far side. This is going to be an absolutely magnificent tussle as they both get past Potts. Ed Hayes has got himself into the lead of the race and is already starting to disappear out in front. Adam Southgate, we ride on board with, is trying to chase down Richard Avery, and we've got two of the 924s to our left. You can see them up the road in front. This could be really tricky to get past both Carl Rossin and Gavin Johnson in the same breath. Round the outside, Southgate tries. Avery squeezes him out. You're not getting through there, Sunshine. And Southgate has to back down off the attack. Plenty of curb use there. If that's not track limits, I don't know what is, but Southgate was bailing himself out of a very nasty accident there. So, well recovered from Southgate. They both get past Johnson and Rossin, not Rossin and Johnson. So, Gavin Johnson there, look, has got himself in a second position. So, while Ed Hayes has been fighting himself back from about P6 in the Boxsters to the lead of the race, Gavin Johnson has fought his own way back from about P6 in the 924s all the way up to P2. So, great fight backs in both classes. Southgate trying to close up on Avery. Hold it, Adam! Goodness me, that was close. That was very nearly throwing it into the kiddie litter on the side of the circuit there. But Richard Avery still running in second position. Southgate in third place. It's a long way back to those behind. Lawrence still in fourth, though, by the way. Stocker and Molyneux are having a sensational scrap for fifth position further back. But these two still squabbling. Avery at his best versus Southgate at his best, as they continue to battle away for what is now second position in this race, with Ed Hayes having scarpered up the road. Southgate's got a chance. He goes left, trying to seek an opportunity. That's Hayes just going through the picture. But can he go right round the outside? He tries to cut back, and Avery's already there. So there's not a lot Southgate can do about this at the moment. Richard Avery just seems to be able to put his car in exactly the right position on the road at exactly the right time to stop the attack from coming. So Avery again holds that inside line. Southgate trying his best to overcut. Has he got a chance here? Well, there's a couple of laps to go, so Southgate may get an opportunity. But Avery is really making it hard work for Southgate in the 45. Great battles between these two. Southgate has a little bit of a look into Abbey, but he can't really commit to that move. Not if Avery's got anything to say about it. He would have shut the door long before they got to the braking zone. So Avery again just tries to keep the speed of the car flowing up towards farm and through village. This could be a really interesting scrap towards the end of this race, but Southgate really wants to get through past Richard Avery. He's got a strong opportunity there, but again, look, every time he gets a good run on Avery, the back of the car starts to stick out, and I wonder if that's because the tyres are starting to go. It's a lot hotter here than we thought it was going to be this weekend, so I wonder if track temperature is causing a bit of an issue. Now, that is Gary Lawrence running right in front of Alex Stocker, so Stocker has caught up to the back of Lawrence. Southgate's alongside Avery. Avery breaks very late. Southgate can cut back across. Cut across, mate. Cut across. Avery's already got on the power, so Southgate can't quite make the undercut. It's a great squabble for second. It's a great squabble for fourth. Kevin Molyneux trying to hang on in front of Nick Hull and Andrew Porter, but I can see that that's going to be the way. But what's happening with... That's Avery's car starting to get some smoke coming off the back of it. Now, I wonder if that's the same sort of problem as we saw at Alton redeveloping, as now we've got Lawrence and Stocker trying to work their way through the 924s. Yellow flags. Somebody's gone off. Couldn't quite see who that was from that angle, but look at Avery's car. We're on board with Southgate, and look, there's definitely something coming off the back of Avery's car there. Now, I wonder, is that a small oil leak? Because there's definitely white smoke coming off the car, and Avery's looking quite twitchy. Now, if he spins off on his own oil, that could be a real problem. And if that is oil falling off the car, dissipating around the circuit, that could be a real problem for the drivers around the racetrack trying to keep it on the black star. There is Gavin Johnson. No, sorry, that's Pip Hammond in the other BDC racing car. We've barely seen him all race because he's been that far out in front of the rest of the 924s. He's at an absolute march to victory here. Now, Southgate's got another chance on Avery. Watch out for the 924 on the far side. That is the 22 of Darren House. Southgate has to bail out of the move, and he ducks back in, but this is going to be an Ed Hayes victory. He won both races at Alton Park. He's going to take the first win at Silverstone to make it a 100% winning success rate from one weekend to the next. Out of the final turn comes Ed Hayes in the 77. What a way to start the Silverstone weekend. Victorious as Southgate tries again on Avery. He's not going to get there. So Avery is second from Southgate in third. Great battle between those two. Lawrence is fourth in front of Alex Stocker, with Kevin Molyneux in sixth position ahead of Nick Hull and Andrew Porter on his first race weekend of the 2017 season in eighth. Baker comes home as the lone production runner, and in the 924s, it is a 1-2 for PDC Racing, with Hammond in front of Gavin Johnson, Ross in his third from Waters, Smith, Lowry, Potts, Jamie Callender and Darren House. Fastest lap for Pip Hammond in the 924s. In the Boxsters, it's that man, Ed Hayes. Three wins out of three, and Rachel will be delighted to speak to him down in pit lane.
Congratulations. You had us guessing there. What happened at the beginning of the race for you to drop back like that?
I just can't get these things going. I don't know how to do it. So I always slip back a little bit on the start, and this time a lot.
Are you happy with the car, though? It was just the start that bedded you down.
Yeah, the car's great. Thanks. Yeah, no problems.
Okay, so looking forward to races two and three tomorrow?
Not really.
Why's that?
Well, it's quite hard work, isn't it?
I don't know what happened then. I had a couple of love taps. I think I'd give Ed a tap, and then you gave me a tap, and then Adam gave me a tap. Lost my headlights somewhere down there. I didn't know until I got back I'd lost it. I had a good start. Ed was a bit slow off the start. Was I leading the race at the start? I remember then. I wish we were thinking, yeah.
We'll come to you in a minute.
Yeah, but no, it was a good race. It was hard work. I mean, obviously, you know, these guys... They're good drivers, you know what I mean? It's no easy win there, so well done to Ed.
Well, it was busy, wasn't it? So I usually get a decent start, so I quite like it when me and Ed are on the front row, because he always gets used to the start. So first corner first, but then this guy was all over me.
Carl Rossen, third, race one, second meeting. Congratulations. That was quite a race and quite a tussle you had out there.
It was a great race, to be honest. Good start. Picked up a couple of places, I think, in the melee in that first corner here at Silverstone, and just plodded along and putting in good consistent lap times. Had Ryan behind me for half of the race at least, and keeping me very, very honest.
Yeah.
And then Gav came in and joined it up, and apparently I was in second place for most of the race, which was a surprise to me.
Hi. And welcome back. It's day two of the Toyo Tires Porsche Championship, round two here at Silverstone. And the cars are already in assembly, lined up for race two. Ed Hayes is going to lead the Boxsters out. Pip Hammond is going to take the 924s out. But will they bring the respective classes home? Jake, I think it's time you took us through the grid for race two.
Well, the grid for race two, refer to the results of race one. If you can't remember that, it's Ed Hayes and Richard Avery on the front row from Southgate and Lawrence, Stocker and Molyneux, Hull and Porter. Andrew Baker, the lone production runner, of course, with Hammond and Johnson on the front row for BDC Racing in the 924s, Rossen and Waters on the second, from Smith, Lowry, Potts, Callender and Darren House. So how is this race going to fare out? Well, it's all up to Ed Hayes here, really. His starts have not been impressive. Let's see if he can get rid of those jinxes. Away we go. And it's another terrible start from Ed Hayes. Yet again, he can't get off the grid. So Avery's going to take the lead. Southgate's going to go with him. So too is Lawrence. We're on board with Philip Waters. as they run through the first corner. It's a better start for Hayes. He's going to try and keep Southgate behind him this time. And I think he's going to manage it into the first corners of the race. If he can keep it up the inside into Village, then he's going to hold third. Yes, he does. He's there on the inside. Southgate's going to run wide, and there's nothing he can do about it. So Hayes is in third position. But another terrible start from the 77 as Hull makes his bid to go for Southgate. Tagged along by Stocker. Oh, Southgate goes off! Southgate overshoots on the run to the hangar straight. He's going to lose multiple places if he's not careful. Back on board with Jamie Callender. Lowry's on our left. Waters is in the middle and Smith is on our extreme right. And it's three wide, almost in the battle between Southgate, Hull and Stocker for fourth position. My word, this race has started out of a good one. Southgate running well, but needing to close up on the leading three already. He's lost a massive amount of time. Avery in the lead. Lawrence in a fantastic second off the start. Hayes is third. And as the Boxsters went their way through, that is Kevin Molyneux. His first weekend of the season. He was on holiday at Alton Park. I bet he wishes he was on the grid. There's the 33. Andrew Porter running through, doing a great job in his first weekend of the 2017 season. And that's what the sight of eight Porsche Boxsters, line astern, does for you. Into Abbey Corner. Second lap. Ed Hayes charging after Lawrence. We're on board with Southgate. P4, plenty of curb. He's got to be careful here because up the inside, that's Hayes going for the move on Lawrence. And Southgate needs to stay on the back of Lawrence to try and get himself up into a podium-paying position. But Avery is your leader. Hayes is there in second. So we've got ourselves a real tussle. Last year's runner-up versus the 2015 champion. Back on board with Southgate. Slightly different camera position you can see for this race. It's slightly higher up the car, so you can get a slightly different angle as to what it's like to drive one of these things. I can tell you, I've not driven a box there, but I have driven an i24, and they're as slippery as anything, but they're great fun to race, these cars. Many a racing driver has gone into this championship and come out of it with a massive smile on their face. Here's Southgate, piling on the pressure to Avery. Hayes in second and Lawrence in third. Gary Lawrence got himself a podium in Alton Park. He'll want another one here. In fact, he'll want another two if he can get there. Fourth in race one, third in race two is definitely a possibility. Nick Hull's going well in the second race here as well. Is it going to be yet another third place for Nick Hull? Well, to do that, he's got to get past first Adam Southgate and then Lawrence. It looks as though Avery's already under some attack from Hayes. So Avery trying to hang on to the lead of this race. Ed Hayes wants to come through. We're on board with Gavin Johnson as they come into the final corner. Trying his best to get past Phil Waters, but Waters is not giving him a lot of space. He doesn't have to. They're racing the position. So it's Hammond leading. Ross in second. Waters third from Johnson, Callender, Lowry, Smith and Potts. Great battles all the way through. Whoa, Ed Hayes makes a mistake. And Lawrence is going to come back at him. Here comes Southgate. He's had an even better line. He's going to try and get past both of them. Up the inside of the hangar straight. And look, more problems for Avery. Dippin' and smoke coming off the car again. He's going to get boxed in. Southgate's got a good run, but he's going to get boxed in. And look, Nick Hull's joining the party. Ed Hayes is going to try and sweep right round the outside. It's three wide into Stone Corner. You can't do that. But somehow they've all made it through. Hayes is still there on the far side, and he's going to get the lead. Adam Southgate's going to dive for the inside of Lawrence. More smoke coming off Avery. He's going to get into third position, is he? Oh, there's definitely a problem for Avery. This is magnificent racing as they continue to squabble here at Silverstone. Magnificent battles here at Silverstone. We're riding on board with Gavin Johnson as he chases down Carl Rossin in the 924 scrap. Great battles in the Boxsters and the 924s in this second race of the championship. There is Ed Hayes having worked his way through the 924s. He's got himself a brilliant lead at this point. So Rossin there in front of Gavin Johnson. Then we've got Waters and Smith. That looks to me like Darren House trying to knit his way around with Ryan Lowry in there as well, the treble one. There's your race leader, though. Ed Hayes, having made a break from the pack, he is back in the lead once again. So the 77 working his craft beautifully as he continues around this Silverstone International Circuit, knitting one corner and one apex after the other. We're on board with Southgate. Definitely got a messed up windscreen. I wonder if that's as a result of Richard Avery's car, because, of course, he had all sorts of smoke billowing out from behind it. Trying to pick up where Richard Avery is around the circuit, actually, I think. He may be out of this one. Richard Avery has worked himself very hard in this race to try and get one over as Southgate laps the 25. Thanks, mate. Try not to get in my way too often, Stephen. Did a good job there, Stephen, to let him go by. Adam Southgate, you've got to say, he's always got time to be a gentleman. Here's Phil Waters as he runs over the curb, trying to chase after another podium in the 924s. Hammond still leading. Ross in second. Johnson third. Here goes Southgate, charging up the inside of the 18 of Peter Smith, trying to do the same thing to Phil Waters without losing too much time. That was nice and easy, wasn't it? Passes one on the left-hand apex, passes the other on the right-hand apex, and now charging after the podium runners. But Ed Hayes running a beautiful race here. Richard Avery, I'm afraid to say, in no end of trouble. It looks as though the gremlins from Alton Park have well and truly returned. So that victory that we thought he was going to go for in the second race is now not going to be, I'm afraid. So Ed Hayes looking to make it 4 out of 4. What an incredible start to the season this is for the 77. He told me at Alton Park he wasn't going to do a full campaign. He'll have to now. Well, that's the battle with Waters as Peter Smith goes through and takes fourth position. So now Phil Waters has got to try and come back at him as Ed Hayes, the leader in the Boxsters, passes Pip Hammond, the leader in the 924s, to put a lap on him. That shows you how fast Ed Hayes has been in this race. He didn't lose quite so much time on the start as he did in race one. So this time Ed Hayes is able to control the pace quite rhythmically as he continues to dart his way through corner after corner. This man is well in control of things here at Silverstone. He seems to be the man to beat. And if this is going to be 4 wins out of 4, well, he's going about it the right way at the moment as he gets himself back onto the main straight. Ed Hayes closing in on Darren House to put a lap on him. Pip Hammond behind him looking for his second win. Here comes Johnson. Is it going to be another 1-2 for BDC Racing? Gavin Johnson would like to think so. Up the inside of Carl Rossin. Bye-bye. Gavin Johnson goes through and takes second position past Carl Rossin. So it looks as if it's going to be exactly the same podium as last time as Nick Hull works his way past Waters up the inside of Smith. And Smith banzais up the inside of Waters. What a move from Richard Smith. Sorry, Peter Smith. I'm getting my worms mixed up again. Peter Smith banzais up the inside of Phil Waters, gets the car stopped on the apex, and what a sensational overtaking move. So a great run there from Peter Smith in the 18. That was beautifully done. That was a bit of a Gilles Villeneuve Dijon 1979 overtake, wasn't it? Absolutely sensational. Now Johnson running in second position. Not quite with his teammate, but it looks as though the PDC Racing boys, their winter of hard work and determination is going to pay off. Whoa, Jamie Callender losing the back end. Well, that was almost the full 360. Well held by Jamie Callender. He'll only have lost about 4 or 5 seconds or so. But Ed Hayes is on the march to make it 4 wins out of 4. We definitely thought that Richard Avery was going to hold a candle to him in this race and maybe there might be a battle for victory. But as it turns out, Ed Hayes is once again the man on form. This is looking very Schumacher-esque, isn't it, for Ed Hayes, running very well out in the front. But he seems to have got the pace of this car well nailed. A glimmer of hope, I suppose, for the other drivers out there is that he still can't quite get a handle on his starts. He's still not really got that job done. But he only dropped to third position on this occasion. How on earth can Adam Southgate see where he's going with that much muck and rubbish on his windscreen? He's doing a great job, but my word, a podium will definitely have been earned if he keeps this up. Now, that is one of the 924s going wide. That looks like Darren House, as Adam Southgate closes in on Hammond to put a lap on him as well. But we're in the closing stages of this second race of the weekend. And it just looks as though every time Ed Hayes starts up the 77, he has a poor start, fights it back, and wins. It's like a video game for Ed Hayes. He's having an absolutely brilliant run of it as he comes out of the Vale chicane, powers on the gas, cokes it through club corner one more time, and the checkered flag flies yet again for Ed Hayes. What a sensational day for Ed Hayes this is turning out to be. 2 wins from 2 starts, 4 wins out of 4 in a row now. And if we look back, it's going to be a similar story for Pip Hammond in the 924s. It's going to be a second position, though, for Southgate. He gets that second place he so richly deserves from Nick Hull in third position ahead of Alex Stocker, Andrew Porter, Kevin Molyneux, Gary Lawrence and Richard Avery, of course. Andrew Baker, the lone production runner. And then we have Pip Hammond as your winner from Gavin Johnson and Carl Rossin. Peter Smith in a valiant fourth place in front of Phil Waters, Stephen Potts, Jamie Callender, Darren House, and the DNF from earlier on for Ryan Lowry in the treble one. So great racing for Ed Hayes and 2 wins out of 2 for both Hayes and Hammond here at Silverstone. Not a bad day's work.
Well, I thought the Colonel here was going to push me at the start. He was tracking me at the beginning there. I think it looked like it started getting squabbly again behind, and it just kills lap times, and obviously I could just make a gap and manage the car a little bit throughout.
And Gavin, second place again. Are we going to see this repeated throughout the season for the power distribution control team, do you think?
Yeah, I'll be coming first. Pip will be coming second. But no, it's great. It's great for the team. Delighted. A lot of people put a lot of work in. We've got a lot of sponsors really help us out. And it's a great result, yeah. I had a good fight with Carl. I did it at Alton Park. So it starts with me to go on, and I feel like I've been in the race. It was good. Really enjoyed it.
And Carl, last but no means least, your car is clearly up for the championship on form, just like your good self.
Well, thank you. It feels great, the car. It's just brilliant racing with these guys as well. Followed Pit round for a couple of laps just to learn where I'm going. And then I was having a great battle with Gav, Phil and Ryan. And I thought, you boys keep sorting yourselves out behind me and I can get away. But they kept biting and biting and biting. So it was fab racing with these chaps. A brilliant result for me.
It was really good fun, yeah.
Ah, there it is, the laugh that's evaded us all weekend so far. What are your hopes for race three? Is it going to be a hat trick?
Nice, but anything can happen, can't it? So it's a big scrap probably in race three.
It's great to have a battle with so many people out there because we've got a race rusty. So to be able to battle and come out kind of on top, apart from this guy, was really good fun. Big thanks to the sponsors and mechanics, Avis Consulting. Great job this weekend preparing the car.
It went really well, and great battle with Adam. I couldn't catch Ed, he'd gone. But me and Adam had a good tussle, and I really enjoyed it. The guys have put a really good car underneath me for this, for the whole weekend so far. So Nick Booth, Lee and Paul have done a stellar job. And the Yacht Millennium Windows, they've sponsored me this year, so that's brilliant as well.
So how do you get better than that? Simple. All you need to do is flip reverse the grid. It's going to be an amazing race, this one. Kevin Molyneux on the pole position from Andrew Porter. Alex Stocker and Nick Hull on the second row. Adam Southgate alongside race three and four winner of this season, Ed Hayes. Gary Lawrence and Richard Avery on the fourth row. Andrew Baker on his own as the production leader, with Darren House and Jamie Callender on the front row for the 924s. Potts, Waters, Smith, Rossin, Johnson, Hammond and Ryan Lowry. This one should be an absolute cracker. Watch for Hayes coming through the field. Watch for Hammond going off the start like a jackrabbit. In particular, Hayes is one to watch because he always has terrible starts. Let's watch this race as we get underway. Southgate's got a good one, but he's going to get boxed in behind both Molyneux and Stocker as we get underway. It's been an absolutely terrific game. Look at Hammond in the 924s. He's going to get past all of them by the first corner. I wonder if he's done it. Stocker leads. Molyneux second from Harlitha. Hammond is in the lead of the 924s already. From the back of the grid, he now leads the 924s. That is absolutely incredible. But Stocker leads it. Here goes Southgate. Side by side with Nick Hull. There's not a lot of room, but they managed to get through without contact. Hull hanging on to third position. Hayes is there in fifth, now behind. That is behind Southgate. Lawrence is sixth, Porter is seventh, and I'm afraid to say that Richard Avery is a non-starter thanks to the engine problems that took him out of the earlier race. So Stocker is leading, Molyneux second, Hull third from Southgate, Hayes, Lawrence and Porter. And then we've got Pip Hammond making the move on Adrian Baker in the production car. What a start for Pip Hammond. He's gone from practically the back of the 924 grid to the front in one straight. What a banzai getaway that was for Pip Hammond. Back on board with Southgate. Molyneux moving to cover Hull. Hull moves across the cutback. Southgate's already there. Hull's going to run deep if he's not careful. He hangs on to it, but Southgate's going to get the undercut back on the inside. But can Hayes make an advantage move here? Well, Alex Stocker leads the way. Kevin Molyneux in second. Welcome back to the championship, Kevin. Doing a great job in second place. Hull is still there in third. Southgate's making a bid to get through. Look at the heat haze over the top of the over the start finish straight here at Silverstone. Very tough, very hot conditions here. So the tyres are going to be all over the place by the midway point of this third and final race. Here goes Southgate up the inside of Hull. Hull trying to defend, but Hayes has got the inside line as well. Now, can Hayes keep this going all the way around the outside? This is going to be tight, this is going to be tense, but Hayes is there to the inside line. Southgate's making a move on Kevin Molyneux already as they go down the hangar straight. Southgate's hesitated. Ed Hayes is going to come past him if he's not careful. Look, he moves across the cover, but Hayes is still there on the inside. Hayes is now going to make the switch back to the middle of both of them. It's going to be three wide. Hayes passes Molyneux. Hull's going to try and pass Molyneux on the far side. Hayes is going to try and beat Southgate to the braking zone round the outside. What a move from Ed Hayes as he's up to P2. This is a sensational weekend for Ed Hayes, and he really is doing it in style here. Southgate in third position. Oh my word, Hull and Lawrence almost come together, and Kevin Molyneux is going to dive back down the inside and keep the position. Hull goes deep. Lawrence is going to get him on the undercut if he's not careful. Hull goes out wide. Lawrence is going to pass him. This is magnificent racing at Silverstone. The Toyo Tires Porsche Championship once again delivering action by the bucketful. Stocker leads, Hayes second from Southgate, Molyneux. Then it is Lawrence in front of Hull and Porter. And Hammond is on his own in the 924s. Is it going to be three wins out of three for Pip Hammond? And more importantly, is it going to be three out of three for Hayes? Because he's going up the inside of Stocker. Well, I'll just check out, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks very much. And Southgate's going to get through as well. And he's got the run on Ed Hayes. This race ain't over. Once again, Ed Hayes has hit the front at Silverstone in the international circuit. And it's going to be three wins out of three unless anybody can keep up with him. But he knows more than anybody out there that it's not over until the fat lady sings. The chequered flag has got to fly before you get three wins out of three. And Hayes knows that he's got to work very hard to keep up this pace. But fortunately, now that he's in amongst the 924s, he can actually use the traffic to his advantage to build up that gap between himself and Southgate. Looking back, he's done all the hard work already. There is Southgate trying to pick his way through the traffic. So now Hayes is actually a little bit balked there by Carl Rossin. He sweeps around the far side, but that's okay. He manages to get through without too much drama. Further up the road, he's still got a few more 924s to deal with, but Ed Hayes working very well out in front of this one, looking for the hat trick at Silverstone. And that's very difficult to do, especially in this third race, where there is actually quite a lot of traffic to deal with. We're on board with the 24. That is Jamie Callender as he swings up the inside of Adrian Baker. Thanks very much, buddy. I'm off. No, I'm not. Baker's back to his left. Callender keeps his foot in. Back to the inside line. And that is the place now, well and truly steeled. Fantastic stuff there. Now up the inside of the 25 of Stephen Potts to put a lap on him for Ed Hayes. And there's your leader in the 924s. How is Pip Hammond doing that? Absolutely incredible. Having started from pretty much the back of the 924 grid, eighth out of nine to be precise, and charging up to the first corner, taking the lead before they've even finished going through Abbey, is quite astonishing. Pip Hammond actually said after the race one earlier in the day, I was a bit bored out there on my own. I needed somebody to race with. Come back, Rick Starr, in orders forgiven. But it looks as though it's going to be three straightforward victories for Pip Hammond to stake his claim for the 924 championship, which was won last year by Linda Warren. So Pip Hammond is looking very good indeed in the PDC racing car to continue his march to the title. Three wins out of three, looking on the cards as we go back on board with Callender. That is Baker in front of us, and there goes Alex Stocker and Kevin Molyneux as they battle away for the 92, as they battle for the Boxster's position, sorry. Down the hangar straight, Hammond is a lone ranger on his own out there in the lead of the 924s. He could really do with a few more drivers to play with. Of course, he's going to get them later in the year because the 40th anniversary of this car is being celebrated later this year with a one-off race at Donington. Get onto the website, porscheracingdrivers.co.uk, for more information about that race at Donington Park in September. That is going to be a race you will not want to miss, especially if you've got a Porsche 924 lying around doing nothing. You should get on the grid and have a great race in it. I've been told there's quite a few drivers from the Porsche Drivers Association who are going to come out and play in that one. So that one could be the race of the season. Here is Adam Southgate. What is happening for Southgate? He's taking it nice and steady through the veil. Meanwhile, Stocker and Molyneux still scrapping away. Molyneux's going to try the impossible round the outside of Stowe Corner. Keeping his foot in, and he's still there. You can see them in the background as Gary Lawrence continues to make his way in front of the 924, number nine of Gavin Johnson, seeking another podium finish, and it looks as though it's going to be a third place. Carl Rossin does seem to have the measure of him in this third race. Rossin in that brand new car, which is really starting to get up to speed now. Second place very much on the cards. Here comes Stocker on the back of Molyneux as we switch back to Southgate. Southgate looks like he's struggling a little bit. He continues to run very strongly in position, but I wonder if he's got a bit of an issue or two. Molyneux now in front of Alex Stocker as they continue their squabble. This is a great duel between these two, and it's great that these friends off the circuit and rivals on it are having another great duel in 2017. Alex and Kevin can always be spotted in the Porsche Racing Driver's awning, having a chin wag in the late evenings at any racetrack they go to. Real fun lovers. Love their motor racing, love their motorsport. Whoops, both Stocker and Molyneux went a little bit over the curb there on the way onto the hangar straight. And that's Ryan Lowry trying to chase them down in the treble one. Problems in race two. Looks like he's back up to full speed in race three. Stocker's having a go. Can he make the move on the inside line? There's not a lot of room, and Molyneux's having to slam the door shut very delicately there indeed. But he's managed to do so. This is very good work indeed from Molyneux as he runs in front of Alex Stocker. So the battle with these two continues. Molyneux having a cracking race. Stocker in number seven there, runs right behind him. This battle probably isn't going to be finished until the very death of the race. So out of the final turn, back onto the main straight. Molyneux looking, moves a couple of inches to cover. There's Nick Hull, looking good in the 66, hoping for another strong race. So is this going to be a Kevin Molyneux victory or Alex Stocker victory in this battle between the two of them? They're working very hard at the moment and they've got every reason to push it. But it is going to go all the way to the victory, this one. Ed Hayes is going to get that, by the way. Pip Hammond looking like he's going to get 3 out of 3. Here's Southgate. I have a feeling Southgate's got some handling difficulties. The car does not seem to be as strong as it once was. Molyneux's actually getting away from Alex Stocker a little bit, so this is going very much his way on his return. Southgate gets back into the chicane. That's Pip Hammond, still running in front of Adam Southgate at the precise moment in time. Closing up on Ed Hayes. Well, these two running together. Ed Hayes in front of Pip Hammond on the road as they continue to run for the victory. Both drivers are looking like they're going to get their third win out of three this weekend here at Silverstone. It's hard enough to win one race. It's really impressive to win two, but to take all three in the weekend, especially with the third race being a reverse grid, is quite astonishing. And considering that both Ed Hayes and Pip Hammond have both proven that not only are they up to the challenge, but in dominant fashion, people are going to have to pull their socks up ready for Cadwell Park at round three. Adam Southgate up and over the curbs once again, trying to stay with Ed Hayes. Second position is well and truly secured at the moment. But he wanted more from this weekend. They still need to find a little bit more pace to Ed Hayes. Whether it's more confidence in the faster corners, whether it's just a little tweak or two here in setup, they will go back and do their homework. Don't worry about that. Cadwell Park, they'll be much stronger. But for now, it's going to be a high five. Five in a row for Ed Hayes as he comes through the final chicane once again. How does he do it? He won both races at Alton Park. He won race one here. He won race two here. Out of the final turn at Silverstone. And that's the hat trick for Ed Hayes. 5 wins out of 5 starts. Ed Hayes is the perfect 10. Absolutely perfect 10. 10 out of 10 for this first part of the season. As is Pip Hammond here this weekend. A brilliant result, and what a fantastic race it's been. So Ed Hayes wins it from Southgate and Lawrence. Hull is fourth ahead of Kevin Molyneux, Alex Stocker and Andrew Porter. Adrian Baker is the Lone Ranger again in the box, the production class. Hammond winning from Rossin in second, Johnson in third in the 924s, from Smith, Potts, Lowry and Jamie Callender, with Philip Waters out of the race. How on earth do they do it? Both Ed Hayes and Pip Hammond are the heroes here this weekend. They started three races, they pushed it to the limit, and they both won three times. Roll on Cadwell Park, as far as they're concerned. Their bandwagon could just keep going.
I bided my time.
Kept the best till last?
I certainly did. You know, I saw what was going to happen, having been in this position before, and just waited and waited and waited, and had some great race in mind, but picked up second place. I'll take that, as an end to a good weekend. Fantastic.
Yeah, and on the back of Alton Park, too early to predict your hopes for the rest of the season?
Oh, I just like taking part. As long as I finish, that's it. Yeah, so very happy. Very happy.
Good, good. And the PDC boys, is this feeling as if it's becoming a habit? Congratulations. I mean, every podium position is hard fought, I know. And it was incredibly hot out there.
It was. It got some nice cool air where I was. I think it was a bit more dramatic for everyone else. But just lit the car up off the line. I've been learning my starts from Carl. He's always been the man. And I think sort of gritted my teeth and went for it. And it was, I think I was first into the first corner. So I was amazed by that. And then, I don't know, it's watch the fireworks in the mirrors again. That was, as there always is.
I'm going to switch to Gavin quickly because I know everybody wants to go home. Gavin, have you got anything to give to chase Pip down in the coming races, do you?
What a great question.
I too can save the best till last.
Well, I can answer that question as championship leader as we leave Silverstone. Hey! And say it's maybe Pip needs to do the chasing. He's exciting. He's mega quick, isn't he? And you know, on track. If he hadn't had the incident on the park, we'd all be chasing him. So I'm looking forward to the challenge. It's been a great weekend for me. My best yet. driving the car. So yeah, onwards and upwards really.
Gary, I'm going to come to you first, third, to follow up on third from Alton Park. Congratulations. You said at the beginning of the day you wanted a podium. You saved it till the last.
Yeah, it's unexpected to be honest, because we were having problems all weekend. But Dave and Lee and my son James did what they could. So no, I was pleased with it really. Lovely weather. Yeah. Couldn't kick up with these boys unfortunately, but no, it was all right.
I saw you with your feet up in the paddock earlier. You didn't look as though you wanted to go racing at all.
I could have sat in the sun, if I'm honest. But, yeah, no, it had to be done. No, it's good.
Well, you might need to take some advice from Adam, because I got an inside tip in the paddock last night that repeated a trick he learned, if not before Brands Hatch 2015. And I believe you're wearing it now. The wet T-shirt that, what, spent the night in the freezer?
That's right, yeah. So every weekend I try and win the wet T-shirt competition. Gary's trying to give me a bit of a run for my money. He's, you know, he's doing his bit.
I've got better cleavage.
He has, in fairness. Yeah. But I've got the wetter T-shirt. So, yeah, to keep myself cool in weather like this, yeah, put a T-shirt, wet it, whack it in the freezer overnight. Beautiful, beautiful.
That's a good tip. Have you got anything mad in the way of top tips to add to that, Ed, to round the day off?
Ed does it with his pants.
Yeah. No.
We have to keep it clean. It is, after all, a family show, Gary.
No tips to keep cool, but that sounds quite good.
And clearly not going to be sharing top tips for keeping top spot on the podium, I suppose.
Nothing to share.
All down to driver talent. Congratulations, Ed. I can't wait to see you out next time.
Cheers.
Well, that's it from Silverstone for this triple header of the BRSCC Toyo Tires Porsche Championship. We've had a triple header of wins from both Ed Hayes and Pip Hammond in their respective classes. So is it too early to call the championships yet? Perhaps it is. It is only round two. And we're off to Cadwell Park in just 3 weeks' time. So make sure you tune in to join us to find out how those championships pan out in the rest of the season.